The long-awaited capture is just around the corner, as SpaceX has revealed substantial improvements to its spacecraft and chopper systems. These innovations have consistently set SpaceX apart from its competitors. Meanwhile, the Chinese government continues to support initiatives to develop analogous technologies, as they aspire to rival SpaceX's achievements. Join us for today's episode of NR Studio as we explore these recent advancements. We are heading into Flight 7, which marks the inaugural V2 flight of SpaceX's Starship initiative. While the mission will be aligned with Flights 5 and 6, indicating that there will be no immediate attempt to capture the spacecraft, this upcoming flight is an important milestone toward future progress. Elon Musk has indicated that the highly anticipated capture of the spacecraft is expected to occur in early 2025, likely starting with Flight 8. While the likelihood of a successful capture during Flight 8 remains uncertain, the continued improvements implemented on Ship 35, which is scheduled for Flight 9, specifically add to SpaceX's proficiency in this domain. You may be wondering what connects Ship 35 to Flight 8. This connection becomes even clearer after examining the recent upgrades. After an extensive period in Megabay 2, the initial segment of Ship 35, which includes the nose section and payload section, was then extracted from the bay. These components had been stacked since early December, presumably awaiting further assembly. This unexpected maneuver revealed a significant number of improvements to Ship 35, demonstrating SpaceX's continued strides in technological innovation. It is worth noting that various positions on both sides of the ship, particularly within the payload compartment, now feature small rectangular openings. These adjustments are consistent with the system that SpaceX mentioned in the Flight 6 update, where over 2,000 tiles were extracted to facilitate the capture support mechanism. The presence of these openings indicates substantial progress in facilitating the capture of the ship on future missions. A more meticulous examination of Ship 35 reveals additional features. In regions where the heat shields are intact, immediately beneath the forward flap, one can observe small apertures. These are presumably alignment points for lifters utilized by cranes to hoist the vessel onto or off the stand, or to stack it within the bays. Generally, there exist four pivotal points to maintain equilibrium during these operations. However, the most striking characteristic continues to be the diminutive rectangular apertures located on either side of the vessel. It is hypothesized that these will function as the attachment points for the chopsticks during the landing phase. A characteristic absent from the initial V2 prototype, Ship 33, this further substantiates the likelihood that SpaceX will adeptly capture the vessel utilizing the new prototype. Notwithstanding these encouraging enhancements, further adjustments may be necessary. Exclusively depending on minimal apertures could introduce considerable risks owing to the acute precision required for a successful capture, particularly in the initial phases. These apertures could be elements of a more intricate system, potentially incorporating mechanisms that deployed outward upon landing and retract when inoperative. Conversely, this may signify a pivotal advancement in SpaceX recovery technology. Should you possess any insights regarding these upgrades, kindly contribute your thoughts in the comments section below. Beyond the fundamental enhancements, Ship 35 incorporates modifications ostensibly aimed at refining the chopstick system for elevating the vessel during stacking operations. In a manner akin to the aforementioned ship catching points, there may also exist two supplementary points on either side. In contrast to Ship 33, where these features were concealed by heat shields, they are now revealed on Ship 35. This apparent transparency indicates that SpaceX may be experimenting with various configurations or that the heat shields have yet to be implemented. This prompts a significant inquiry. In the absence of heat shields, can the chopstick lifting points and the ship catch points endure damage during reentry? During Flight 6, we noted discoloration and deformation in tileless regions, highlighting the susceptibility of these unprotected areas. SpaceX may mitigate this issue by implementing partial heat shields in the critical zones or by integrating sophisticated cooling systems to safeguard them during reentry. Guaranteeing the longevity of these components is essential for the sustained reusability of the vessel, necessitating that SpaceX implement effective strategies to protect them. Concerning the implications of the Flight 9 prototype indicating a potential catch in Flight 8, it is noteworthy that the nose cone and payload section for Ship 34, designated for Flight 8, have yet to be disclosed. In light of the recent upgrades implemented on Ship 35, it stands to reason that one might anticipate corresponding enhancements on Ship 34. Should SpaceX successfully implement these enhancements, the prospect of capturing the ship during Flight 8 transitions from aspiration to viable objective. Conversely, should Ship 34 be devoid of these updates, SpaceX may reallocate missions, opting to launch Ship 35 for Flight 8 while allowing Ship 34 additional time for enhancements prior to Flight 9. Considering SpaceX's swift production capabilities, Ship 35 could be prepared in time for Flight 8, thereby reducing the likelihood of delays. It is my aspiration that Ship 34 is likewise afforded these crucial enhancements to maintain operational consistency and preparedness, thus circumventing any potential disruptions. The coordinated progress within both ship and chopstick systems highlights SpaceX's conscientious strategy in enhancing their technology, thereby facilitating harmonious integration between the vehicle and ground operations. Essential for the success of a V2 operation, the enhancements to Ship 35 closely resemble the recent advancements made to the chopstick catching system that we previously deliberated upon. Through comprehensive analyses and visuals provided by Chrome Kiwi on X, we have acquired significant insights into these enhancements. A 3D representation produced by Chrome Kiwi distinctly illustrates the disparities between the outdated and contemporary lifting pins. The revised edition features a rotating black ring equipped with a bearing, which enhances the adaptability for linking and aligning the super heavy booster and vessel during the processes of lifting, lowering, and stacking. This adaptability is essential for achieving accurate alignment during catches and may establish a foundation for subsequent catch attempts. The newly upgraded lifting pins exhibit a close alignment with the enhancements observed on Ship 35, highlighting the extensive scope of SpaceX's innovations. What are your predictions regarding SpaceX's potential endeavor to ship catch on Flight 8? We invite you to share your insights in the comments section below, and remember to like and subscribe for the latest updates on SpaceX's pioneering voyage. Undoubtedly, SpaceX's swift progress with Starship is outpacing its rivals, especially Blue Origin and United Launch Alliance. As SpaceX propels the frontiers of innovation and transforms the tempo of space exploration, it appears that others are noticeably trailing in comparison. Consider, for example, Blue Origin. The eagerly awaited Glenn rocket is unlikely to take flight this year. The hot fire test, an essential milestone in the realm of rocket development, has either yet to be executed or, if performed, has not been publicly disclosed. Failing to fulfill this prerequisite renders the acquisition of the essential launch license unattainable, thereby deferring the launch date indefinitely. This delay will have a considerable effect on Blue Origin's objectives, especially with regard to its Mars spacecraft launch mission for NASA, notably as SpaceX advances towards complete reusability through its innovative two-stage catch system. Blue Origin continues to contend with the fundamental hurdle of achieving reliable orbital access. This marked disparity in advancement represents more than merely a reverse in fortune. This situation reflects poorly on Blue Origin, drawing attention to the significant disparity in capabilities and aspirations between the two companies. Despite encountering its own delays, ULA's upcoming USSF-106 mission is anticipated to launch prior to April 2025. By that time, SpaceX may have already showcased its capability to capture the upper stage of the Starship, an achievement that would further highlight its technological superiority. Compounding ULA's difficulties is the ongoing Cert 2 issue, which remains unresolved and has impeded launch certification, further hindering its efforts to maintain competitiveness. As SpaceX forges ahead, the outcome of the 2025 space race appears to be all but predetermined. Globally, SpaceX's supremacy is increasingly overshadowing its rivals in China. One notable company, LandSpace, has distinguished itself as the most successful in replicating SpaceX's methodology. Recently, LandSpace revealed a substantial influx of funding amounting to 900 million yuan, equivalent to $123 million, sourced from China's National Manufacturing Transformation and Upgrading Fund. This significant investment will be allocated towards the developmental testing and production of the Metalox reusable launch vehicles, with a particular emphasis on the Zhujue family. The Zhujue 2 rocket, which has garnered significant attention, executed a successful launch in November, transporting a 4-ton payload to sun-synchronous orbit. Capitalizing on its current momentum, LandSpace is concentrating on the advancement of the Jujuy 3, which is anticipated to have its inaugural launch in 2025, with intentions to implement first-stage reuse by 2026. In September, LandSpace successfully executed a vertical liftoff and landing test of the Jujuy 3 over a distance of 10 kilometers, demonstrating significant advancement in their endeavors. The Jujuy 3 rocket boasts impressive dimensions, standing at 76.6 meters tall and 4.5 meters wide. It possesses the capacity to transport 21 tons to low Earth orbit in an expendable configuration, 18.3 tons for downrange missions, and 12.5 tons when returning to the launch site. Its primary purpose is to facilitate resupply missions for China's Tiangong space station. While LandSpace has made significant progress, its progress has been driven largely by substantial government funding and a strategy to emulate SpaceX. This practice illustrates a trend in China's private aerospace sector, where companies often copy designs and innovations pioneered by SpaceX. Despite these efforts, such a strategy can limit their capacity for independent innovation or hinder their long-term sustainability. In contrast, SpaceX's innovative strategy and robust development pipeline clearly distinguish it from its competitors. With its ambitious plans for the coming years, SpaceX appears poised to outpace competitors like LandSpace and its imitators. While imitation may offer fleeting advantages, authentic leadership in aerospace requires innovation, adaptability, and qualities of independence, attributes that SpaceX has consistently exemplified. As SpaceX continues to reshape the world of space exploration, it is clear that mere imitation will not be enough for its competitors to seize the industry's dominant leadership position. The trajectory of space exploration is now entirely in SpaceX's hands. That's all for today's episode. See you next time.